Volume.
Hello.
Woo! Hello. It's great to be here and what appears to be Letterkenny's own version of the Moulin Rouge. And these lovely ladies here have already agreed before the show they're going to do a little number for you afterwards. Don't be shy. Woo! It's great living here in Letterkenny. I must say, I moved from Ballandrate where there was like, you know, not a lot going on. And like, it's so great the way everyone goes around Letterkenny, all hyped up on coffee. Oh my god, I'm not quite sure what's wrong with me. I only had 7 espressos, I just can't seem to hold it together. God, and but being from Ballandrate too, I'm a bit of a country girl in the city world. I keep saying to everyone, oh, it's great being here in the city, it's so culturally diverse, there's so many people. Oh, there's people from all over the world. And they're like, Deirdre, it's Letterkenny, it's not a city. If you were from Ballandrate, you'd think of it as a city too. If you were even suspected of drinking coffee in Ballandrate, the scandal, the neighbours would be at their wee net curtains going, Jesus, Patricia, do you see that Italian doll who moved in next door? Don't trust her. Don't trust her. Oh my god. Isn't it really weird when you're in hospital lying up on a drip, you know, oh, feeling sorry for yourself, oh, this is so shit. You get this really condescending, you know, like, I don't know, auntie, granny, you know, darling, you're in the right place. And you think, where the fuck else would I be? I'm sick. You know, you want to come up to them and say, yeah, you know, when I started coughing up blood and fainting, I thought, I'll go down to the gym and sort this out. But now, my sister, if anyone knows about Shabam, no? Woo, 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 you. I didn't know it was so popular. But anyway, she had a weird experience with the doctors, Mr. Bam. They said to her, if your chest infection gets any worse, you come straight back, does she understand? And she was like, okay. So she did get worse, and she came back that night, and they said, you know what they said to her? They said, no, that's normal. That's perfectly normal. I mean, like, if you come blue, come back to blue. Seriously, how sick do you have to be? So we did the logical thing. Like, we dressed her up as a Smurf, and we sent her back that night. Anyway, I'm a woman that you might have noticed, you know. I really don't understand feminism. I really don't. You know, all this, we want to do everything men do. We want to do everything men do. What? Why? Like, you don't see very many feminists going around with a big bag of coal off the lorry. I just feel so liberated these days. Ladies, it's called manual labor for a reason, you know? Oh, God. But also, living in this culturally diverse, magnificent coffee-fueled place has a lot of benefits too. For example, I have a lovely Polish boyfriend now, very exotic, makes me 10 times more interesting and exotic than before, or so I tell myself. But my friends look at our relationship very naively and a bit racistly, I must say. I don't even think they're aware of it. They say things like, oh, your boyfriend, what do you call him again? Vladimir or something like that? Yes. Everyone from Eastern Europe is called Vladimir. Yes. A friend had asked her, was having coffee with me? Of course, coffee. Like, and she said, so, you know, he has good English then. And I'm so tempted to screw around with him, you know. Because I think they think our relationship is like this, you know, in the morning. A woman, I want breakfast. A woman, let's go to cinema. A woman, I want sex now. You know? I don't know what they expect. But, of course, Polish is a frustratingly difficult language to learn. Of course, it's difficult if you struggle to learn English as well. But I've learned the key essentials that any girlfriend needs, you know, that any girlfriend needs. And they are, yeah. Which means no, and Botak, which means because I said so. But anyway, dating is quite complicated, you know, especially when you're coming 30, because it's basically like going to the rubbish dump and searching through painlessly, trying to find the least broken thing there to take home with you. And guys, I'm going to, right here, I'm going to tell you a wee secret, right? You should write this down. He's got his notebook and everything. If a girl says to you, if you can't handle me at my worst, then you don't deserve me at my best. What she really means is, I'm a lunatic. Oh. I was touch and go if anyone's going to know about this, but has anyone heard about Caitlyn Jenner?
Yes.
Oh, right, okay, so you know, okay, right, so I'll try. So I'm totally behind Caitlyn Jenner, strong, confident, independent woman of the year, fantastic. It takes a band to be woman of the year these days. But all I'll say that if you ever doubted that Bruce Jenner, can't say that now, but if you ever doubted that he was a woman, like, how else can you account for his bad driving skills, you know? Anyway, life's complicated. Facebook, dating, feminism, doctors. But I'll leave you with one piece of life advice. It served me very well. And I apologize to my mother, who's just off the boat from Loch Derg, for saying this, and my aunt as well. Sorry. But women can't fake orgasms. It's true. But men can fake the entire relationship. Thank you.
Oh, we love you.